Greetings all, and thanks for tuning in for this Paranormal Pit Stop. Tonight, we'll be exploring an iconic saloon located at 240 Bourbon Street within the French Quarter of New Orleans, Louisiana, that's widely recognized for its famous green monster, an absinthe frappe comprised of Anisette, Herbsaint, and soda water. Purported to play host to a number of ghostly presences tied to its past, are you sure you're ready to brave the history and hauntings of the Old Absinthe House? Historically, a first version of the structure now housing the Absinthe House was initially constructed in 1752. However, sadly, this original structure was burned to the ground through the 1788 Great Friday Fire, and following, all that remained was little more than foundation and a fireplace. Preceding the blaze, parties would rally together to reconstruct the site quickly. In 1807, Pedro Front and Francisco Uncedelia of Barcelona would establish a general store within, and for the next four decades or so, the pit stop would act as a popular trading post for food, tobacco, and liquor. In 1815, the property's ground floor would be converted into a saloon known as Alex's Coffee House, which was operated under the nephews of Senora Uncedelia. And in 1874, following famed mixologist Cayetano Ferrer's creation of his legendary green monster Absinthe Frappe, the business would re-establish itself entirely as the Absinthe Room. Unfortunately for the Absinthe Room, on October 1st of 1912, the US government would officially ban the importation and sale of absinthe. And while later, through the start of Prohibition, what was by then called the Old Absinthe House was ordered to cease its services entirely, ultimately, the establishment would continue its dealings as a speakeasy, until authorities literally had to threaten to burn the place down for management to cooperate. But even then, while they did in fact cease operations on site, management would really just move everything down the road to the more secretive 400 Bourbon Street location instead, where what was called the Absinthe House Bar would continue slanging its green monsters to both trusted locals and to those lucky tourists who were deemed kosher and who received rare invitation. And really, can we blame them for fighting a government attempting to destroy their livelihood simply because it couldn't take a piece for itself? Or maybe the owners of the Absinthe Room were some of the historic few to perceive the slippery slope of submitting one's liberties to a system claiming democracy, all the while sowing the seeds for a wealth-based monarchy. Whatever the case, we think we'd knock back a green monster or two in honor of their good fight. Following Prohibition, the original Absinthe House site would continue to operate as a bar, and was passed through a handful of owners. In 2004, the whole of the premises would welcome a full renovation, which included the reinstallation of its authentic copper-topped bar, and following the year of 2007, when absinthe was finally allowed back into the US, this old watering hole's fabled green monster would once again be placed back on the menu. In the present, the Absinthe House site remains open and serving, offering a range of unique drinks alongside unparalleled food options, while also hosting the Rue Bourbon parlors and balconies, which in itself offers a variety of French Quarter venues for reservation. Quite classically, the whole of Absinthe House bounds are rumored to be haunted not by restless spirits, but by the souls of those who form deep bonds with the establishment in lives since past. And those living now frequenting the property have reported a range of supernatural phenomena, including doors that open and close on their own, bottles, chairs, and other items spied moving around inexplicably, and disembodied footsteps, voices, and whispers detected from vacant spaces. Several investigations of the expanse, some of which that have even been performed by high-profile teams, have yielded extreme EMF fluctuations, crystal-clear EVPs that include conversations, music, and more, and odd thermal grid activity, while others have told of their drinks going suddenly missing and of run-ins with shadowy manifestations. Extreme cold patches have been felt in adverse weather, and eerie laughter has been heard occasionally from just out of sight, and various full-bodied entities in clothing spanning the eras have been sighted gliding about sometimes after close, and some of the more prominent of which purportedly include Andrew Jackson, Benjamin Butler, and even Marie Laveau. Several additional manifestations reported across the bar include that of a woman in a long white dress that walks up and down the stair, that of a small child who likes to play pranks on the living, and that of an unknown presence who brings with it an unnatural chill. A final and quite famous legend claims that at one point, Major General Andrew Jackson would actually arrange a meeting in secret in a second floor chamber of the Old Absinthe House with none other than John Lafitte just prior to the Battle of New Orleans. While some question the validity of this tale, this hasn't stopped reports of sightings of a spectral figure bearing a likeness to Lafitte, who's often described as clad in his signature pirate hat and attire, and seemingly brings with him the ruckus of a long-forgotten party. Thanks for joining us on this Paranormal Pit Stop. If you enjoyed hearing our histories and ghost stories, subscribe to our channel, like this upload, and share us with anyone you feel could use a good scare. We'll catch you next time.